I was about to ask if you have a web browser on here, but I just realized we just installed this OS and there's nothing on here.
Well, we have Edge.
So no, you don't have a web browser.
No.
One, start. Here we go. Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really? That's just great. I'm doing pretty great today too, because today I'm gonna solve one of my personal biggest mysteries, and I'm not alone. I'm with Maniac Mike.
Hello.
Hey, this is actually his MacBook Pro that we're stealing here. So the goal today is we're gonna install Adobe Premiere on Windows and then Adobe Premiere on macOS, both on the same hardware, and we're gonna see which one performs faster, because I've heard stories and lots of rumors that Windows works way better with Premiere. Premiere is way more optimized for Windows than macOS. So we're gonna see if we can get the same result today. And I have a lossy drive here with footage that I shot from the upcoming Volume 2 of Vintage Apple Vault. The public has not seen any of this footage yet. Actually, you guys right now are gonna be seeing this stuff before it gets released for the first time. So that'll be our test footage for today. However, that drive is working with boring old USB type A. Aww. That's not gonna work on this new MacBook Pro. So, Maniac Mike, what do we use to save the day?
I have what is called the Uber dongle of conversion technologies.
Yeah.
Which is the hyperdrive.
The hyperdrive, so.
It has, if you flip it on over, mm-hmm. It uses two Thunderbolt 3s to pass through to two more Thunderbolt 3s. And then you have a micro SD and full size SD, mm-hmm. along with two, which are very important, USB type A's running mm-hmm. at I believe 3.1 or 3.0 spec.
You betcha.
And if you look at the top, you also have an HDMI out.
Fan-freaking-tastic. So I was about to ask if you have a web browser on here, but I just realized we just installed this OS and there's nothing on here. So
do you have a web browser? Well, we have Edge.
So no, you don't have a web browser.
No.
I'm kidding. Honestly, full disclosure, I like Edge. When I use Windows, I'm totally cool with using Edge.
They are building a version of Edge that uses Chrome.
I've heard that too. So let's go to adobe.com. Okay, we're gonna go to Premiere Pro CC, download that. In the meantime, do you mind if I plug this in and then swap your power into the
thing? Oh no, it goes on the other side. Because this—
Oh duh, because it—
There's four Thunderbolt 3s on here.
Yeah. I have to reach all the way over there. Okay, I'll do it. It's okay. I'm really just... go ahead. You know what? You're here. Contribute. Yeah. Plug that shit in, too.
So it just goes in right there. And what's nice about this is that it just blends in with the rest of the case.
And bon appetit. There it is. Setting up device. We're setting up USB key... What? Device is ready. It thinks it's a keyboard. We'll plug this in. We're probably going to get one warning about the HFS volume that's on here, but the XFET volume should work just fine. Select a skill level. I don't know. Advanced? I don't know how smart I am. We'll say continue. Okay, so we're installing Premiere Pro there. Now, in the File Explorer, what we'll do is we'll take the Premiere test drive, and here is that footage from the upcoming Vintage Apple Vault Volume 2. We'll just move this stuff to the desktop for now. And we're gonna build a project inside of Windows, and that same project is gonna be used for the Mac test as well. There's gonna be no other variables. We want a controlled experiment. Premiere is starting up, gents and lades. Lades and gents. I don't know where I was going with that. Let's do a thing. Man, I don't think I've ever used Premiere like on Windows before, but it's pretty much the same thing. Let's get the learn panel out of the— oh wait, I just did Command W, shit. I'm so— no, how do I get rid of this? Okay, I meant to do Control W to get rid of that.
Yes, because Command in Windows is Windows key.
Yep, thanks. I figured that out. I kid. All right, so the thumbnails work. That means the ProRes is being interpreted just fine.
If you drag it into the timeline, let's see what happens.
Yep, it should just automatically do it. Nice. So this stuff was shot on a Blackmagic Ursa Mini 4K in ProRes. So far, that's just scrubbing like nobody's freaking business. Now, since we're not doing a serious project here, I'm just gonna take the soundtrack and remove that. We're just gonna focus on the video here. So this is some A-roll. This is a Hap. I interviewed him. He's a prototype Apple collector, and he will be featured heavily in the upcoming Vintage Apple Vault Volume 2. So we have his interview here, and we have some B-roll shots of for example, the Apple Walt prototype, so we can insert some of that stuff. So let's just go, we're just making a little experimental thing, right? So we'll just get like a little slider shot here. We'll do in, out, and we'll drag that into the timeline as well. And then we'll just truncate that there. So now we just made basically like a just barely under 2 minute video with some A-roll and a couple B-roll shots. And to just add a little more complexity to the project, let's open up Lumetri and just add a little bit of color grading to it. Just a little saturation boost and a little bit of a contrast boost just to give it some more stuff it has to compute. So before, after. All right, so that should be G2G, good to go. And this should all be in 4K as well. Hush, hush there. Midnight, do you want to be the stopwatch keeper or shall I be it?
Rock, paper, scissors it.
Oh, okay, I see how it is. You'll have to bring your fist like around the monitor though. All right, rock, paper, scissors to see who is going to be the stopwatch keeper. All right, ready? Rock, paper, scissors.
Oh, wait,
that doesn't...
Shoot.
Let's try that again. All right, how do you do it? One, two, three, shoot? How do you do it?
It's rock, paper, scissors.
Shoot. All right, rock, paper, scissors, shoot. All right, yes. You get to be the stopwatch keeper.
Woo!
All right, so I'm going to command M the... Oh, that's minimized. Gosh darn it. Control M. All right.
Everything, all your timekeeping will be done on a Google Pixel 3.
All right, I just need to type in a few settings quick. This will just be our test export. So what we're going to do is we're going to keep it in 4K resolution, H.264 for the sake of deliverability, and we'll just do a direct export, no media encoder. So I'm going to click it. Right when you start, I'll give you a 3 countdown. Ready? 3, 2, 1, start. Here we go. All right, so the fans are kicking in. We're at 2 minutes, 44 seconds remaining.
Closing in on just about a minute here.
Still going. Ooh, those fans. Ah, listen to that. We just passed the halfway mark. What time are we at there, Maniac Mike?
We just crossed over 2 minutes, 10 seconds ago.
All right, so maybe in about 90 seconds, we'll be done here. Then we'll take the exact same project, exact same everything, copy it to the Mac partition, install the exact same version of Adobe Premiere, and export with the exact same settings and see how long it takes on macOS. When it goes away, now. Okay, so 3 minutes 52 seconds to export the about a minute 58 second video in 4K, right? So if we go to our Explorer, go up a level, here's our test export in H.264. And as you can see, looks perfectly fine. So now, let's save that. Move this to the macOS and see how long the render takes on the exact same hardware, exact same everything, except a different operating system. Ready to go?
Yep.
Let's do it. All right, we are rebooting into macOS now. Finger on the Option key. And Macintosh. So let's open up the exact same project. This has been copied from the bootcamp partition back to the Mac partition, bouncing away. And Maniac Mike, you will be the timekeeper once again.
I mean, I don't even know what that thing is on the splash screen. Anyways,
it's hovering. It's abstract. What is mountains and
like? I'll
rock?
Be honest. It looks like panties.
Great. Now I can never unsee that. It's like a floating rock, but yeah, I guess it's a yeah. Great.
I'm sorry.
No. It's fine. It is what it is. Oh boy. All right. Opening the project. It should relink the media automatically. Once it loads up here. So far, this is good. We got a white screen. Oh yeah, we're bugging out. The canvas isn't loading. So in terms of optimizations, yeah, it looks like we've already found one problem. It just does not want to work on macOS in general. Oh, that's nice. Shit. Okay, so bug. We got a bug there. Let's relaunch. Gosh. All right, let's try that one more time. Because this is, 2019. Oh, now media encoder finished in the background there. Good timing, at least. Maybe that's what caused it to bug out. I have no idea. All right, that was way quicker. Okay, so in terms of scrubbing, that looks like it's the same performance. That looks good. All right, so get your stopwatch ready. We're going to Command M, throw this into the rendering. Make sure it's the exact same settings. We'll put it in the exact same place. Actually, we can't give it the exact same name because the other one's in there. We'll call it test... Goals. No, just kidding. Two. Test two. So we got that. It's in 4K and it's in H.264. So ready. I'll give you a 3 second countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. And we are now rendering on the macOS and we'll see what our time is. It's bouncing around a little bit. It's almost at 10% already. Okay, so we're coming up on 50% complete at...
at about...
145-ish.
Yep.
All right, and we're at the halfway point right now. It's at 147. Notice how the fans aren't spinning like crazy, though. Isn't that weird? Like, I'm looking at your CPU usage. It doesn't seem very high. I don't hear the fans. We heard the fans in Windows, though. Maybe we should have had, like, the task manager open to see how much power was actually using.
Yeah.
But it looks like it's close to the same render time so far. That's interesting. Okay, so we're coming in at 90%. We're at 314. Oh, we had pi there for a second. 314. All right, get the thing in view and get ready to stop. 94%. And remember, don't stop it at 100. Stop it when the window goes yep. away completely. And now. Okay, so really, it was only like a 10-second difference. macOS was 10 seconds faster, but I don't know. That that's not too earth-shattering. It's about the same. Yeah. The performance scrubbing was the same. The export time, yeah, it was 10 seconds faster, but I'm not going to, you know, lose sleep over that. So, yes, this was just one experiment with one acquisition codec and one export codec, but, I mean, for me, that's what I mainly use. I acquire in ProRes and I export in H.264, and from this test, the scrubbing performance and the export performance was exactly the same. So I think we can say optimizations in terms of playback and exporting, it's the same. I don't really care.
Aside from being on the same hardware, really the 10-second difference doesn't really make that much of a difference.
No, and it could be, but you know, even it then, could fluctuate like, sometimes maybe.
Even then, like being able to edit, like it's performing very smoothly.
Yeah, like this is two ProRes 4K clips on top of each other. It scrubs like butter. It's fine. Yeah. Cool. Well, I'm calling that like it's a tie between the two. Like, it's fine. The experiment worked. Nothing's better than anything else, really, in this case. So, thanks, guys, for watching. And again, Vintage Apple Vault Volume 2 is coming really soon. Catch the Krazy. Pass it on. Thanks, Maniac Mike.
Yep.
Yay.
Bye.